After the election, Democrats now hold a so-called supermajority in both houses of the legislature. That means that they can pass a number of laws without any Republican votes. To talk more about this, Assembly Speaker John Perez joins us live from the KCRA 3 newsroom this afternoon. Thank you for being here with us.
Thanks for having me.
Did anyone expect this to happen? Did you expect this to happen? Were you surprised?
Look, I always knew it was a possibility, but it wasn't one that many people thought was real. Everybody expected that we would end up with anywhere between 51 and 53 Democrats in the Assembly, and not very many people ever thought there was a hope to get to the 54 supermajority number. We did it because we had some phenomenal candidates who connected well with the voters and talked about the important issues of getting people back to work and continuing to stabilize the economy of the state of California, building on the successes we've had working with our governor over the last couple of years.
Already, Speaker Perez, there's been concern even voiced in that press conference with the governor about now the supermajority and Democrats raising taxes. Is that a real concern that people should have?
Not a concern at all. That's never been something that we've suggested would be our priority, and it's something that the governor's been very clear that he wouldn't do without a vote of the people. The action yesterday by the voters on Prop 30 was a clear demonstration of the governor's commitment never to put forward a tax increase without taking it directly to the people. We understand where the governor's coming from, and our focus is in stabilizing our economy as we have with him over the last couple of years and continuing to grow jobs. We're thankful that California is now growing jobs at a faster rate than any other state in the country, but we've got a lot more work to do before we get everybody back to work. That is our key priority.
So you'll honor the governor in what he says and that he won't raise taxes without the votes from the people?
We're very clear on that.
All right. Now, does a supermajority mean that you'll have to hold members of your own party accountable for any inaction?
We always hold ourselves accountable for action and for any failure to take up an issue that's pressing before the people. But we agree with the governor as well. We need to govern in a bipartisan way as much as possible. And I'm proud that in the entire time I've been speaker, I've found ways to bring Republican members into the decision-making roles with us. I've appointed Republican chairs of committees and have consistently found ways to get Republicans to vote for us when we needed their help in two-thirds vote in the past to close loopholes that didn't make sense for California businesses in the way that Prop 39 did last night. And we're committed to continuing to work in that way. What the two-thirds means is that day one, we have at least 54 members coming in to serve in a way that's focused on job creation and stability for our economy.
Assembly Speaker John Perez, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. We sure appreciate it.
Thank you.